Hello guys, today we have one more topic to understand in income tax, which is meant for 5th semester BCom in many universities. What is the topic is encashment of earn leave. Leave means what? Leaves means when the employee is working, the employer will give 3 to 4 types of leaves. One is called as a casual leave, that is called as a cumulative leave. If you don't avail some leaves in a year which is given to you, such leaves, unavailed leaves, unused leaves, you can carry forward for the next year. That is called as a cumulative leave. One more is there, sick leave. When you fall sick, the employer may be given 1 or 2 leaves in a year so that you can utilize it when you fall sick. There is one more type of leave which is given by the employer, which is called as encashment of earned leave or earned leave. That means, when you apply leave, you will be paid for the leave you applied as well as the salary which is to be paid when you applied leave. That means you will get double, you know, double dhamaka, means 2 benefits you get. Say, suppose if I apply 1 month leave, I'll be paid salary. See, though I have applied salary, I'll be paid 1 month of salary freely to me. That is what the employer is paid when I have taken an earned leave. That is called as an earned leave. What happens, suppose, if I don't take leave and if I work, then I will be paid an extra amount of salary apart from the salary which I worked in that month, which I have not taken. I'll be paid salary as well as extra salary also will be paid to me. That is what we call it as an encashment of earned leave. See, in case of encashment of earned leave, there are 2 types of encashment you can take it. You can take earned leave when you are during the service. See, for example, I worked in a company for 3 years. So, if the company is given 1 month earned leave for me in a year and I have not taken any leaves, and I will get 3 months salary as a freely given by employer, which is taxable in which year I will go take it, because still my service is continuing. If I take any earned leave during the service, which is completely taxable. But when this benefit will be available, when this benefit you will get is, if you take earned leave, encash the earned leave only at the time of retirement. Now, for the purpose of encashment of earned leave salary, employees are divided into 2 categories. One is a government employee, other one is a non-government employee. In case of government employee, encashment of earned leave salary, any amount of earned leave which he is taking or taken at the time of retirement, it is completely exempted. Please make a note, at the time of retirement, if he takes, it is fully exempted in case of government employee. In case of non-government employee, it is not completely exempted. It is partly taxable, partly exempted. Now, we should know how much is exempted, how much is taxable. When you want to know how much is exempted and how much is taxable, then we will come across with the rules. What is that rule? We have to understand it. See, now I told you, in case of encashment of earned leave salary, employees are classified into 2 categories. One is government employee, other one is a non-government employee. In case of non-government employee, any amount of encashment of leave salary drawn by employee at the time of retirement is completely exempted. But in case of non-government employee, it is partly taxable, partly exempted. Then how much it is exempted? See, there is a rule. Computation of earned leave. See, computation of earned leave. What is the rule says? Actual earned leave received at the time of retirement. How much? We will write it here. Less least is exempted under section 10, subsection 10AA. So, first one is actual EL amount. Whatever the actual amount you have taken here, same amount you have to write it here. Then, maximum limit is 3 lakh rupees. 10 months salary. Means we take salary of 10 months. See now, sir, what is this salary? I will write it here. Salary for
EL, that is on leave, is basic salary plus DA, it should enters into retirement benefit plus commission, and this commission should be based on percentage on sales.
Okay, same as when we discussed in gratuity not covered, whatever is the salary for the purpose, same. So basic salary plus DA enters into retirement benefit plus commission percentage on sales. Suppose if any dearness pay is there, there is no need to require to enter into the retirement benefit, automatically by default it will come, dearness pay and basic pay. But here we should take dearness allowance, it should enter into retirement benefit. So this is the salary for the purpose of earn leave. Okay, so whatever the salary you get, that salary amount into 10 months, we will take it here. Then what is the fourth point here is, average salary of 10 months means we take the average of the salary into leaves not availed as per the IT rules. I will discuss about this now. What is the leave not availed as per the IT rules? See, as per the IT rules, every employee will be given 1 month leave, 1 month leave for every completed year of service. Every 1 month leave for every completed year of service. That means if you complete from the day 1 to 365 days, 1 year completely, you will get 1 month leave. That is the rule as per the IT rules. Suppose if your company, if your employer is given 1.5 year, 1.5 month or 2 months as a leave in a year, completed year of service, then you will be paid extra money. Am I right or no? So therefore, we take, it will be restricted to only 1 month as per the IT rules. So here, average salary of 10 months is, we have to calculate here. Now, you will understand clearly when I will take it here. Okay. See, leave not availed as per the IT rules, average salary of 10 months. All of you got it, guys? Now, let us see how to calculate this. Mr. X retired on 1-1-2018 after serving 34 years and 9 months. After serving 34 years and 9 months. He was entitled for 1 year, I'm sorry, in XYZ Limited from 1-10-2017. See, XYZ Limited is a non-government. So now, Mr. X is a non-government employee. He was getting salary from 1-10-2017 to 31st of December 2017. His salary was 8,000 per month. See, if you take 1-10 to 2017 to 31st of December 2017, it comes to, hopefully this is 16. So 1-10-2016 to 31st of December 2017, it comes to 10 months. So 10 months he was getting 8,000. That is what we need, because we need the average salary of 10 months. So we can take it as a 8,000 rupees here as a salary for average salary of 10 months. And what else he is given? He was entitled for 1.5 month. Please make a note here. Every year he will be given 1.5 months. 1.5 year is nothing but 1.5 months as a leave for his completed year, every year of service. And he received, availed him in his service 30 months. That means 1.5 year he was given as a earned leave every year, and leave availed by him in his service was 30 months. How many months he was taken the availed is nothing but used. Number of months used or taken the leave is 30 months. And leave salary received at the time of retirement is 1,68,000. Now let us write how much he received is 1,68,000. We will write it here. Now what is to calculate taxable amount of EL? Now let us see how to calculate this. Now there is no DA is given here. Does he given the DA? No DA is given. Does he given the commission? Commission is also not given. Now what is the salary for the purpose of EL is 8,000 rupees. Am I right? Now we can answer for the third point, that is 8,000 into 10 months, it comes to 80,000. Now the most important is how many number of leaves is not availed. How many number of leaves is not availed? Now if you check with here, see number of service, how many years is taken? 34 years. How many months he worked? 9 months. Always for computation of earned leave, we ignore the fraction of months completely. We never take the fraction of months. We consider only completed year of service but not the fraction months. Now the company was given, as per the IT rules, you will get for 34 years of service, for 34 years of service, if you get 1 month for 1 year, for 34 years, how many months you will get? 34 months you will get. Am I right? How many months already he has taken avoid? How many months he has taken? 30 months he is already taken. Then how many months he is not taken? Only 4 months he was not taken. Am I right or no? Yes. He was not taken 4 months. Now how many months he was not taken as per the IT rules is 4 months. What is the amount of salary? Average salary of 10 months is 8,000. Now 8,000, 8 fours are 32. So that is 32, 3 zeros, 32,000. Now just check with which is the least of these 4 amounts. 1,68,000, 3,80,000 or 30. It is 32,000. Definitely it is 32,000. Now we get 1,36,000 rupees is the taxable year. What is this? Taxable year. See, this is a very, very simple, okay, very simple question. And I want to tell you one more thing. It was asked in the year 2013 for 6 marks. After 2013, that means 14, 15, 16, 17. He did not ask this question for Bangalore University for 6 marks at all. My dear students, this year, in the year 2018, I am sure you will get this question for 6 marks. Please get ready for this question. Okay, if you have any doubts, if you have anything to comment, please don't forget to give a comment. And please don't forget to subscribe channel Sai Study Circle. And don't forget to press bell icon. Thank you so much. Now we'll see the second question, because in the first question we understood the basic rules how to compute the taxable portion of encashment or leave salary. In one problem you don't understand much. That's the reason I have taken the second question also. I will read out the second question. Mr. Mohan is a non-government employee. He himself is given a saying that is a non-government employee. He is not a government employee. If he is not a government employee, then we have to take these rules. We have to compute the taxable portion of year. He is a non-government employee who receives a 28,000 rupees of what? Earned leave amount. That means he received 28,000 rupees of earned leave amount. So here also I will take 28,000 rupees of earned leave amount. Okay. Now what else is given is salary at the time of retirement. See, he retired on 10th March 2017. 10th March 2017, say we will consider it as 10th March 2018 because 17 is a preceding to the previous year. No problem. So 10th March 2018. So we were taken 17. So 17, 10th March 2017, which falls in preceding to our previous year. So I have taken it as a 18. So in this previous year, he retired. And on the basis of the following information, we need to compute what is the taxable portion of year. Now, since from 2016, he was getting 4,000 per month. And he was not given, after that, is there any changes? So we consider basic salary as 4,000 rupees only. And nowhere else he is given what is the DA amount, if commission, nothing is given. So salary for year
is basic salary plus BA if it is enters into retirement benefit plus commission on percentage on sales. Here basic salary is 4000 per month. BA is not given, commission is not given. We have taken only 4000. Now easily arrive with third point, 4000 into 10 months, it comes to 40,000 and the maximum limit is 3 lakh rupees. Okay, now what is left out is the fourth point. What is required for us is how many number of lease is not availed. For this, we need to find out how many years is served for. See, if you check with here, duration of service is 16 years 4 months. See, anyhow, this 4 months we will ignore it because we will not consider for the earned leave. Then how many years he completed? 16 years. As per the income tax rules, how many months you will, for every 1 year completed year of service, you get 1 month of leave. For 16 years, you get 16 months. Am I right? And now, let us see what else he is given. Leave at the credit of him at the time of retirement is 7 months. That means, as per the company, he has got 7 months is not taken any leaves. It is as per the company, but not as per the IT rules. See, as per the IT rules, he will get only 16 months as a leave because he worked for 16 years. But what is taken is, what other point is, EL is for 45 days for completed year of service. That means company is given 45 days. 45 days is nothing but what? 30 days, 1 month, 15 days, half month. That means he was getting 1.5 months, 1.5 months as a earned leave for the given by the company. As per that, see, I will show you 16 years into 1.5. See, 16 into 1 is 16, 16 into half is 8, 16 plus 8 is 24 months. Am I right, guys? So, from 24, how many leaves he was taken? 17 leaves he was taken. How many leaves is left out? 7 months. This is as per the, not income tax, as per the company. On this basis, how much he was paid? 4000 was the salary for him. 4000 was the salary. So, 7 fours are 28. On this basis, the company was paying. But what we need is, we need to know as per the income tax. As per the income tax, 1 year, 1 month, 16 years, 16 months. Now, let us see how many leaves availed in the service. See, how many leaves is already taken? 17 months is taken. Now, if you deduct 17 months, you are getting 1 month extra is taken. That means, he is not at all left any leaves as per the IT rules. That means, he will get 0 months. We should not take negative year. We can take it as a 0 months. So, what is the salary? Is 4000. Am I right? Now, 4000 into 0 is 0. Am I right? See, that is the difference. This calculation is as per the company. This calculation is as per the IT rules. As per the IT rules, he is not getting any leave at all. He has completely utilized 16 months for 16 years. So, you are getting 0. Now, if you check with this, the 4 amounts, which is the least biggest amount is, least amount is 0 only. Least amount is 0. That means, he will not get any exemption under section 10, subsection 10AA. So, thereby completely 28,000 rupees will be taxable EL as per IT rules. So, 28,000 is the taxable EL. I hope all of you understood. Guys, in this question, very simple. Everybody will get confused because if you look at here, the leave at the credit of him at the time of retirement 7 months. So, if you take this 7 months here, your answer is absolutely wrong. Understood? Because this 7 months, what he was not taken, this is as per the company. But as per the income tax rules, he has taken excess leaves. That is 16 months he is supposed to take, but he was taken 17 months. He will not get any benefit as a earned leave exemption. Okay? So, I hope you understood encashment of earned leave salary. And in my next video, I'll be teaching you
pension computation of pension, taxable pension portion. Please guys, subscribe my channel Sai Study Circle, and please don't forget to share it to your friends, because it is a very valuable video. I have made it for you, and it will be very much helpful for preparation of your final year examinations. So thank you so much. Please don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you.